7272, first reading by title, moved by Counselor Stephen Kelly, seconded by Counselor Eric McGarry. On the question, Counselor Graham.
Yes, Your Worship. Thanks to the presenters of the reports, I have one question of staff, perhaps, maybe that's you. I'll ask that for Your Worship. The first point of Mr. Darcy's presentation, he talked about a flood risk study. And in my report on Regent Street, we have its importance. And we often hear people talk about how they have a chance to look back at that city, probably the same way. We can look at the city for a long time, and I think they do in this city here. I would like to know if this study exists, if we wanted to see such a thing here at City Hall to better inform us to make this decision and have a comfort zone ahead. Could you request that of UNB so that we can include it in our information? It seems like it would be a relatively critical part of the puzzle. I know my constituency, Santa Clara Platte, did experience flooding and did experience a tremendous amount of water. And if what Mr. Darcy says is the case, then it would be reflected in a study, or it's expected to be part of the study, should the resource have been dedicated to do that. So I guess the question to the staff would be, does the study exist? And if it doesn't, could we at least, prior to making the next wave of decisions at third reading, have some information back on this, on specifically what Mr. Darcy is saying in his first question he asked.
Just correct me if I'm wrong here. The question is, we have the flood risk calculations done with respect to this project?
I think the question was along the lines of, has UNB undertaken a flood risk study, and what are the details surrounding that?
Mr. Raffleson, Mr. Smith, anybody want to respond to that?
Good evening, Your Worship. Councilors, my name is Richard Smith, and I represent AEI here on behalf of the Councilor Graham's question with respect to flood. As you can appreciate, the project is in the early stages, of course, waiting for approval. With respect to a flood risk analysis, will be undertaken as part of that for the particular development only. It's not with respect to the entire UNB Woodlot. For the entire UNB Woodlot, that question was just asked to the administration. Councilor Ray.
Just with that, Your Worship. So, any flood risk studies that happen or will be undertaken are specific to the PIDs that will be seeing the development occur on, and not specific to the surrounding properties, and certainly not specific to the city as a whole, or can you just narrow down the scope of what?
Mr. Smith?
Certainly, Mr. Graham. When you undertake a flood risk analysis like that, each particular development may present a different situation, of course, depending on the nature of that development. And so in this particular case, represents highway commercial properties. And so the analysis will be done with that in mind. Of course, when you do that, you look at the particular property, the inflow from upstream of that property, and the impact that it would cause downstream. So you look at the system as a whole.
That's right.
So, through Your Worship, has any of this information been brought to City Hall? I mean, if we're looking at making a decision on something like this, and this isn't the first time that Mr. Darcy is going to be representing on this. In the past, I've certainly voted in favor of moving forward on specifics of woodlot development. However, I would like to know if there are any risks. Just to blindly turn a cheek on this and not to make the decision with the information that might be out there would be sort of foolhardy. And I'm just curious as to the process, if we're approving preemptively something without, I guess, the information of both the micro impacts and the macro flooding to the downtown, potentially, to my constituents. Is there any way we can get our hands on some information about what might be out there?
Councilor Graham, just to add to that as well, but the city does have guidelines that they ask all the developments to adhere to. And of course, I can't predict the numbers today, but those numbers of the analysis will be done under all of those guidelines. And so there is an element of risk and an element of requirements that need to be met as a minimum standard.
Thank you. Mr. Lee?
Through your worship, Councilor Graham. As Mr. Smith has alluded to, the city does have some stormwater guidelines, and what they do is they discuss how developments will develop and how they control the stormwater runoff. There's a no net increase in stormwater runoff, and each stormwater runoff, that's a requirement of the developments. So as they get to their design stage, once they know what is being turned to hard surface, what was the previous conditions on the site, they then attenuate the flows accordingly. And that's why you're seeing attenuation ponds crop up around the city, and there to hold the water back when you change the surface from, say, a wooded area to a grassed area, to fields, to parking lots, to buildings, etc.
With that, Mr. Graham?
Thank you very much, Your Worship. Thanks for all this time. So, I guess, is there any point in time at which council takes a chance to see these things again, once development gets sort of closer to a more concrete stage? Just so that there's some type of security on that, I'd be able to mitigate it in a meaningful way. Or is this something that once it leaves council, it's the last we see, or at least on our end? Elders?
Typically, these are technical requirements that are prepared by professional engineers such as ADI, and it's I'm not going to be reviewing them. The only people that can review them with any certainty is our engineering department, who do work with the any kind of consultant to confirm that what they are proposing does meet and achieves the intended result. So, it's highly technical information. It's it's flows. It's it's just information that typically lay people, in my mind, can't readily refute or make comments on.
Mr. Graham?
This is my last comment. I'm certainly not interested in refuting anything, but there must be somebody within City Hall that can bestow or convey our confidence through that. I'm just wondering if at any point these things come up and who that person would be that we communicate with to ensure that this is considered and sort of in an ongoing manner in here.
Your Worship, like any development, I mean, our engineering department does review these plans, and it is a requirement of any development. And again, when a professional engineer puts a stamp on that plan, if there's any kind of failure with the system, the professional engineer in his or her company is responsible for the schematic and the plans that they put in place and to ensure that they were built as designed. And so again, we typically haven't had problems in the past, but Mr. Lee may wish to elaborate on that. That's the system that's in place now.
Thank you very much. I may say something that not to the motion, but what has just been asked. One thing that has been said this evening that certainly makes a lot of sense, at least to myself, is flood risk calculations. And I used the example back a few years ago when there were houses built up here that impacted people down here, and the people were not very happy about it. I heard Mr. Darcy say it's going to be 2 years until these things can, flood risk calculations can be reviewed or changed or whatever. I would like to think that any development that takes place in the city or any other place should take into account flood risk calculations. I think it's prudent to do that. And I'm not sure at what stage we're at, how much we do that or take into consideration, but it seems to me there's always reaction to a reaction. And I would like to think that as counselors, that we do put some stock in what the future holds. And I think the whole issue of flood risk calculation is one that makes a great deal of sense. And I think that if those are going to take 2 years before they can change them, I think we should be able to run that and make it happen, because there is an impact in everything we do. Heavy here.
Thank you, Your Worship. Just in regards to that, I'd like to put a question to Sean and Mike. When you talk about flood risk calculation, as Sean mentioned, I believe he said all developments have to have a net zero impact on stormwater. So I'd like to ask Sean, is that not taking the flood risk calculation into effect when you look at development? It does have to have a net zero impact on water flow on stormwater. That's exactly what they do here, Your Worship.
If I may, my question on calculation is based on this zero. What that calculation is based on, that's what I'm thinking. I'm thinking about the rain events where we can't calculate on it. It happens, but I'll ask Sean
They based the calculations on the best available science today. So they have idea curves, various things that they use. They use computer models to generate the flows. So the intention is that if a development goes in above stream of an existing development, that the downstream properties are not going to be adversely affected by that. One of the things we've also done with our diet is we've created a thing for our major system or the culverts, the rivers, the streams, that there's a 20% additional increase in the size of those pipes to compensate for global warming and changes in the weather that we're seeing. So our major drainage systems are going to be 100 year event systems with an additional 20% capacity for that system as well. While all the development is also being integrated to hold back the flows.
Okay, thank you. Is there any other questions from the council? We have a motion on the floor. Thank you, Mr. Smith. We have a motion on the floor. That is to give bylaw Z2727 first reading by title. It's been moved and seconded. All those in favor of the motion signify in the usual manner. Opposed? Deputy Mayor.
Just a quick point of order, Your Worship. Did we receive the immune report?
Yes.
All the floor.
Those opposed to that motion? Motion is carried. Motion to give bylaw Z2727 second reading by title by Councilor Stephen Kelly, seconded by Councilor McGarity. Is there any discussion of the motion ready for question? All those in favor signify in the usual manner. Opposed? The motion is carried. The matter will be dealt with in 2 weeks from tonight, third and final reading. I want to thank those that presented this evening and thank those that come up to answer questions.